ఇక పోలవరం నిధులపై రాజ్యసభలో వైసీపీ ఎంపీ విజయసాయి రెడ్డి ప్రస్తావించారు. పోలవరం ప్రాజెక్టుకు సంబంధించి కేంద్రం నుండి రావాల్సిన 3805 కోట్ల బకాయిలను త్వరలోనే విడుదల చేస్తామని కేంద్ర ఆర్థిక శాఖ మంత్రి నిర్మలా సీతారామన్ హామీ ఇచ్చినట్లు ఆయన గుర్తు చేశారు. పోలవరం చాతయ్య ప్రాజెక్టు ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ జీవనాడి అన్నారు. పోలవరం ప్రాజెక్టును త్వరగా పూర్తి చేయాలన్నదే తమ ప్రభుత్వ లక్ష్యమని కేంద్రం నుండి నిధుల కోసం ఎదురు చూడకుండా ప్రభుత్వమే సొంతంగా ఖర్చు చేస్తోందన్నారు.
Has an annual compounded growth CAGR of about approximately 11.13% between 2016 and 2020, and therefore all the reforms are welcome, sir. Sir, the bill proposes to give statutory backing for DGCA and BCAS and AAIB. And it is in order to help India in its safety ranking worldwide, enabling us to get more routes in high revenue routes in the USA and other international market. This is definitely welcome, sir. However, I have a few points to be brought to the notice of the Honorable Minister and yourself, sir. The government can be commended for having increased the ecosystem in the aviation sector with more than 100 operational airports, 680 aircraft, and 19 crore trips. India is the third largest in the aviation market after China and USA. Sir, the increased air activity, however, has led to near air misses, which is really a cause of concern, which I hope the Civil Aviation Minister will definitely address it. Sir, the increased cases of accidents, more particularly tabletop runways is short runways and in the hilly areas, and we have seen accidents in Mangalore and recently in Kozhikode also, sir, and this is really another cause of concern. Sir, I have few more suggestions to be made to the Honorable Minister. The convergence of defense and commercial airports, because for example Visakhapatnam Airport, which is operated by Airport Authority of India as well as Navy together, this has therefore caused some problems in increasing the flight connectivity to the executive capital of Andhra Pradesh, sir. The bill does not specifically address such problems, so I request Honorable Minister to address these issues, sir. When civil aviation sector is deregularized, these are all the infirmities, sir. The bill increases the power of the central government, has increased control over the sector, and right from the appointment of DGCA, director generals of DGCA and BCS, few points.